depression of the times. As a psychology and black studies double major, Millington and Morton were my homes. But I see Morton didn't get the memo. I stand before you as a licensed professional counselor of the Commonwealth of Virginia, a licensed clinical professional counselor of the state of Maryland, an approved clinical supervisor in both states, the owner of, are y'all asleep yet? No? Okay, good. I figured you didn't come here to hear me espouse what can be gloomy. Instead, you probably want to know why black therapists only constitute 4% of master level clinicians. Why there are only 2% psychiatrists and 2% psychologists, yet black people make up 13% plus of the United States population. Why people of color prefer a therapist of color. How I am able to consistently stand atop the medical box instead of operating within patriarchal majority norms. And how even with a double major from the oldest college of the South, I would still find obstacles along my professional journey. So I can hear the sighs and groans reverberating through the audience. Not another one of these entrepreneurial researcher alumni types coming back to tell us five steps to success. But that's where you're wrong. That's not what I'm going to do today. For those who follow me on Instagram, hashtag not your average therapist. Instead, I want to increase your brain's plasticity. Shift what we mean when we say therapist, licensed mental health professional, entrepreneur, influencer. Our prestigious education, experiential knowledge, and the culture of social media will lead us to believe we can start a private practice and in 3 days have a wait list. Or that entrepreneurship is for everyone. Or my favorite fallacy, you have to be partnered to succeed in your dreams. Writing a book didn't make me rich. Owning a private practice in a consulting firm doesn't make me any less scared of business. Instead, these conduits taught me how to derive a viable vehicle to change one life at a time, whether client or colleague.